Mandagi to traditional music and dance, the 2016 Okinawa Festival will have it all. We welcome Tom Yamamoto. He's the president of the Hawaii United Okinawan Association, and Vince Watabu, Okinawan Festival Chair. And we have with us, we're tickled to have with us, Andagi Master Chef Ellen Higa. Good morning to everybody.
Good morning.
Let's get right down to the main attraction here, Andagi. Ellen, what makes a good Andagi?
I think it's the batter. We need to have a good, consistent batter. One's not too soft or not too stiff. That, you know, it makes it hard to dry. It gets it very heavy. But, and then, of course, the right temperature of the oil, too, as well.
Okay. Well, let's get started. Vince, I got to ask you, this year, 34th annual, what's new with this year's festival?
Well, since Ellen talked about Andagi, we're having an Andagi eating contest.
I love it.
So all you need to do is come, eat a lot of Andagi, and whistle.
Whistle.
You need to whistle at the end.
At the end. Easier said than done sometimes.
Right.
Yeah. Easier said than done.
So that's one of the new things. The other thing is we have a giveaway trip for two to Okinawa.
Oh, that's awesome.
And that's going to be from Discover Digest Asia and China Airlines. And the other thing that's new is we have a booth with Blue Zones.
Blue Zone.
Yeah.
The Blue Zone program. Tom, what is that?
So Blue Zones program, actually Okinawa is designated as an official Blue Zone where people are living productive, active, vibrant lives well into their hundreds. So Hawaii wanted to adopt this program to promote, you know, healthy lifestyle. So we have a booth this year for the first time at the Okinawa Festival.
34 years.
34
Pretty
years.
Pretty darn amazing that
yes.
you started off humbly, continues to be a very humble event, but so much success. What's the secret?
The secret is, well, aside from it being a cultural festival, we have over 2,000 volunteers that are among our 50-member clubs. So they are actively volunteering in all the different food booths. As far as entertainment, they're part of the performing arts group. So it's a tradition that we've kept up and perpetuated for so many years.
It's all about culture. We're going to wrap this up in a minute, but I know, Chris, you're supervising over there.
I'm ready to taste it. But I noticed, Ellen, how do you make the perfect shape? You just kind of squeeze it out of your hand.
Right.
And then you add some water.
Some water so that it doesn't stick too much, but I just kind of squeeze it and I, you know, cut it off either with my thumb like this. And then drop it. Some people use their finger or chopstick.
She makes that look easy, but
she does.
I'm not
even going to try it. How long does it take to fully cook?
Well, about 8 to 10 minutes.
Okay.
Right, on the right temperature, but these are a little small, so maybe a little bit faster.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, you know, when there's food, there's Tyson.
Oh, yeah. Eat and then whistle at the end.
Right.
While Tyson's consuming, don't forget you got to do the.
Well, that is hard to whistle.
Oh, gosh, okay.
Oh, okay. Hard though, sir. No, it's going to be a challenge.
I want to put some information on the screen. It's happening Saturday and Sunday. Different hours, so check our screen. It's Kapilin Park Bandstand. Additional information, we can go to OkinawanFestival.com.
Yes.
Yep.
Or the Facebook page as well. Go to K212.com as well for more information. We'll have some posted on our website. Always good to see all of you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
I can see the whistling is going to be a challenge.
Oh, I'm
going to come down.
Okay. We have much more coming up on Wake Up Today, including a much more coming to you from Manoa Jai Live at the Central Pacific.